Hey y'all, it's Zeth. I am subbing again this week. So today's topic, or this week's topic really, is numerology and astrology. We kind of get to pick one of those, or both of them, and just go from there. So I'm going to probably stick with numerology just because I am not the person really who has the hugest understanding of astrology. It's something I'm starting with right now. It's something I am studying and focusing on in my own personal practice and what I am trying to pick up at the moment, but it's not there. If you'd given me a few more weeks, I could have given you a better video, but the show must go on. I'm sorry the side of my face is quite a bit darker, but when I turn on the light, I look like a ghost, but I'll probably just stick with this one anyway. So, when it comes to numerology, it's not exactly something a lot of people know about. Excuse me, my family's upstairs if you just heard that cough. Hope she's still alive. So the idea behind numerology, at least with names, or really with anything, is that you're able to condense the letters in names or places, or the numbers within, you know, dates or whatnot, and basically condense it all using a series of conversion and reduction and math and whatnot, condense it all down to one number. And that number, each number has its own vibrations, it gives off its own energy, they generally tend to stick and mean with different things, and they interact with each other in different ways. It kind of reminds me of, this is probably gonna date me, there was an episode of Kim Possible. It was a Disney TV series, it was an animation series, where everyone was obsessed with this book, and you'd answer these questions, and at the end, you would be a red fox, or you'd be a green frog, or you'd be a purple dragon, or you'd be a blue koala, or this, this, and that, and then everyone was obsessed with those, and then how they interacted with each other, and, oh, I can't hang out with you because you're this, or we won't get along because you're that, or I don't like him, and I think he's, you know, a real nerd, he's a dork, and I'm not into him, but he's a, you know, he's a this, and we're compatible, and kind of reminds me of that almost in a little bit, but it's not dealing with your personality. It's working with numbers. So the idea is that everything, all numbers can be reduced down to a number 1 through 9, and then from there you get, I mean, there's so many different kinds of numbers. There's master numbers, destiny numbers, personality numbers, that are achieved by when you break down different things. But let's take the name, Bill, for example. So every letter in the alphabet can be broken down 1 through 9. So A is 1, B is 2, E is C is 3, on and on. So you go from there to 9, so I is 9, and then you start over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then you go through one more time, in which place Z will be an 8, so it's not completely, totally covered. So if you were to break down the name Bill, a B is a 2, A, B is 2, I is a 9, and then L's are 3. So you would add 2, 9, 3, and 3, so that's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Not the greatest math off the top of my head. So the name Bill gives off 17, but it's not a number 1 through 9 or an 11 or 12. Those are also very big numbers. You do not reduce numbers 11, and not 12, excuse me, 22. So 1 plus 7 is 8. So the name Bill gives off an 8. But you wouldn't necessarily use the name Bill unless that is the full name on the birth certificate. Usually, you know, it would be something like William. And usually don't just go off someone's first name. You try to get their full name as it appears on the birth certificate. Women, if you get married and change your last name, or really if you change your name at all, that does not change anything. It's the name given to you at birth. I mean, it's things like that. You can boil it down to, you know, the names of towns, locations, dates. I know people who have not gotten married on certain dates because they didn't want to use a number that, you know, they didn't want their big day to boil down to a number that came out to a certain day. I know people who didn't want to, I don't say didn't want to name their child a certain thing, but they changed the spelling a little bit of their child's name to fit a certain number or to avoid a certain number. I'm not saying that all numbers are bad, they all have their strengths and their weaknesses. I'm all over the place with this one. I am so sorry. A little frazzled right now. But then, so to take, you know, the rest of someone's full name, you would do their middle name with the same idea, their last name with the same thing. So let's say Bill's first name really is Bill. That is Bill's entire first name. So Bill is an 8. His middle name is a 3. His last name is a 2. Let's say his last name boils down to a 2. So you would So you would add up 8, 3, and 2, which would be 14. 1 and 4 is 5. And then that's what Bill's full name would be. His actual number would be a 5. Coincidentally enough, that's my number. I am a 5 within my own physical, personal, mundane name. That is me. I am a 5. I'll do this kind of stuff at work. When I get really bored, I serve, and it's either really busy or really not. I will do it for other people, or I will bust down names of just people I know, and people will see me going down with names and just taking down numbers with stuff, and it's weird at first, but actually I gain popularity within my little group of coworkers. And by my little group, I mean I work with about 550 other people, and they'll see me and they'll ask me to do it for them, and it gets interesting. If you want to learn more about it, you can definitely check it out online. I'd also recommend, I know of this podcast that I listen to that is absolutely wonderful. It is called Season of the Witch. You can catch it. I know it's on iTunes. I use Podbean to get it. Because they used to not have it on iTunes, and that was the only way you can grab it. You should probably switch over to iTunes, but it's already there. They're wonderful. They take whatever topic is at hand, and they'll do, you know, their show based on that. But before that, they will do the number, the zodiac. Right now they're going through every astrological sign, and they're breaking them down, but they're going through every number and what each number means, and I don't know if they're still doing it, but they were doing every tarot card and breaking that down as well. So it was a nice little series continuation. Definitely learn about it more that way. I find the podcast pretty interesting. You can always just look it up, Google it. Very simple Google search will do you guys well. Sorry I'm kind of rambling. It's kind of a last minute video that I was told I had to do to sub in, and I'm just in that kind of state of mind today. So thank you so much for bearing with me. I will see you guys later. Toodles.